how to save your graphs. So there is an export button that you can use on the plots tab. If you want to include the saving of your graphs in your code, so in your script, then you can use the ggsave function. And of course, which arguments does it need? The name of the plot, the file that you want to generate. So the file name would be pcaplot.png, for instance. And then he will save the plot under this name as a PNG file in your working directory. Other arguments that you have to give, which plot to save. If you have given your plots names, then you can choose the one that you want to save. The default here is the last plot that you generated. You can set the device argument, so what kind of plot you want to generate, a PDF, a JPEG, a PNG, an SVG, whatever. You can set the resolution, very important, because the journal that you want to publish in will say it has to be at least this resolution, so you can set that here using the DPI argument. The default resolution is 300, but you can increase it. Then your file will just become bigger, but you will get a nicer resolution. You can set the height and the width of your plot. If you don't set it, it will be the same as in your plots tab. So for a heat map, for instance, you have to increase this because then it will be much nicer. When you set a width or a height yourself, you also have to set a unit. What is a unit? A unit can have these values, so inches, centimeters, or millimeters. It means that the numbers that you define here represent either inches or centimeters or millimeters. If you don't want to include it in your script, you can do the same thing here with export. So you can save as a PDF, and that's a useful format because it will allow you to make additional changes to your plots later on. So in other software like Inkscape or Adobe. You can also save as an image. So here you also have different formats. So you have, for instance, SVG. Well, SVG will also save your figure in a format that you can still make changes in Inkscape or Adobe. That's also a good solution. If you don't want PDF, SVG does the same thing. You will be able to import it into other software. You can also save it here as JPEG or PNG, for instance. This is really as an image. Then you can no longer change it. You can put text on top of it, for instance. You can still do that. But the image itself, it's pixels. You cannot change them anymore. So here also you can set a width and a height. You can change that. It's always good, if you change the width and the height, to do this, then your text will stay nice. And here you just define where you want to save it and what the name of the file is. You can see here that what you can't do is you cannot set the DPI. Yeah. So if you want to set the DPI, then you have to use the ggsave function.